Now it's time to talk about one of the newest models in the exclusive lineup. This time it's the MC A Mono. All our model lines has a mono variant, both the 2M, the quintet, and the cadenza. And this is the first mono in the exclusive series. So why did you make a mono high-end cartridge?
Well, there are definitely high-end customers out there that also want to listen to their mono records in the highest possible quality. So this is a question about being able to give them a really good cartridge for that purpose as well.
It looks like the MC A95. I assume it's related. How did you start designing this?
Well, it's definitely based upon the MC A95. So the housing or the frame is the same, and a lot of the stuff is the same.
Is it also the same stylus type?
It is the same stylus type. It's a replicant 100.
And can you use this for listening to mono records?
Yes, of course you can. It's really nice for listening to mono records. Well, we can compare. This is the replicant 100, yeah. And this is sort of a typical stylus that many people would use for listening to mono records. This is a spherical stylus. Yeah. We also have that on some of our other
cartridges. Yeah, most of our monos would use the spherical.
Yeah, some of them would use the spherical. And the thing is that this is what originally might have been used to listen to those mono records when they were produced many years ago. And this is also sounding nice, but definitely this one, where you have a much sharper edge, so it goes more into the groove, will get out more information from the record. It's quite obvious if you compare those two. So in my opinion, this will get more information out, but if people would like to have something like this, well, they can choose a different cartridge, but for the MCA Mono, where it wants to sort of be really true to the groove,
yeah,
this makes sense.
Which would also fit in with this being an exclusive high-end cartridge.
Sure.
So we start with the MCA 95, we use the same stylus. Which other changes did you make to the MCA 95?
Well, if we need to go from stereo to mono, we need to go in and do some stuff inside the magnetic system, or more specific, the armature.
Yeah.
So the armature would normally, in a stereo cartridge, sit like an X, cross-shaped, so that you will have the two channels left and right like this. But if you only want to have a mono signal, which is a lateral signal, you will then twist it like, so it's a plus sign. And then you would only have windings on the horizontal bar of the armature.
So can it still move vertically?
It still can move vertically just as much as it could before. So in this way, it would be no problem to use it on a stereo record. It will not destroy the stereo record.
So what's the benefit of using this type of armature for mono playing, for mono cartridges?
Well, it's definitely, as I was about to say, it's you can use it on any record without destroying it. So if you're playing a record and you by accident would put a old-fashioned mono cartridge on a stereo record, you might destroy it if the cantilever was not able to move in the vertical direction. But this can move in the vertical direction, so nothing would happen. You would just only take out the mono signal from the record.
You can use it for both without hurting any of them.
Yeah, exactly.
If you were to use an MCA 95 and an MCA Mono trying to play the same mono record, what would you experience, or what would the benefits be of using the MCA Mono?
Well, in a perfect world where the record was really perfect and the cartridge was really perfect, every angle, every alignment was really perfect, then there would be no difference.
I'm sure we don't live in a perfect world.
We do not live in a perfect world. So what would happen if you would use a MCA 95, a stereo cartridge, would be that you would get some noise and some signals out that you really do not want to hear if you want to listen to mono. For mono, you would only want to sort of detect the lateral, the horizontal signal, and nothing else. So the listening experience would be that if you have a mono cartridge on this mono record, you would have a sender image, which is just basically point-like, just middle between the speakers. If you use a stereo cartridge for the same record, it would be more diffuse and really not centered as precise as it was before. So there would be some spurious effects that you do not want. But you can do it, but the best experience is to use a mono cartridge for mono records.
We have a very strong cartridge with some strong components. What does it sound like?
Well, it's closely related to the MCA95. So a lot of the signature, sound signature you have from the MCA95, we will have here again. And of course, we use the semi-non-magnetic armature as we used before.
Yeah.
And so it's a really nice, dynamic, open sound, really nice, sort of everything that you want from a really good mono cartridge.
Makes sense. And I think that it's a really good add-on to have in the exclusive series, to have a high-end performing mono cartridge.
Yeah, I think it's a good idea as well.